time for porting and airflow theory. A lot of you guys saw a training video I was making on accident. Steve Rob corrected me. He's like, you were using your video editor to upload instead of uploading directly to YouTube with the file, weren't you? I apologize. I won't make that mistake again so I can keep my channel clean for its public versus unlisted purposes. That said, it's time to get back to working on porting and airflow theory 3. One of the rules for successfully porting your engine is that you need to focus on the areas of the greatest restriction. I already gave R.H. Kipps quite a bit of information about this, so I hope he still enjoys this video. But as you know, when you have a valve, you've got your stem and you got the circle on top. Okay. Now, a lot of people think about how big the valve is and they think that that's how much flow they get. But you actually get a lot less flow than that going around the valves into your engine. If you think about your valve and the space behind it where the combustion chamber is, when it lifts off, the area behind the valve in the shape of a cylinder is the only space that the air can go sideways outside the valves. That's why I'm always going about working on getting rid of machinist ridge around the valves. Taking a look at my cylinder head design again, I'm worrying a little bit more with R.H. Kipps here because it may not be as good of an idea as I thought, at least on my cylinder head, because if you look at those pictures I put up in the last video or my articles, you can zoom in on it real easy on the website. The kind of a bowl of the combustion chamber is that the valves, the four valves and the machinist ridge all create this kind of shape. So yeah, there's a machinist ridge that's interfering with getting the valves cleared off so that you actually have to have more lift before the flow starts. But in general, the shape of a hemisphere, like a semi-hemispherical head, is going to be lost a little bit if I demachine those valves. I'm going to take the risk. I'm going to do it anyway. I'm just telling you that that's probably part of what the engineers were thinking, creating that nice, more rounded shape, because flame front, when you burn fuel, actually creates more of a round shape naturally than a cylinder shape. One of the rules of porting that I get from David Vizard is that you want to focus on where flow is most restricted. If you break this rule and focus more where the flow is not restricted, you make a lazy port. So take, for example, a port. Okay, port coming up to the valve. When you have this nice port, a lot of people hog that out, and yeah, it can make more power when you're running at a very, very high RPM, but it's not a very streetable idea. It's not even a race idea if I was to race my Chevy Prism or Corolla, because the way the automatic transmission works on this car is it only runs at low RPMs until you're going really fast. So if you're going to do some kind of slower speed street race, you would never even get into the higher RPMs. So where all your power is at, you'd be losing the whole time. So let's review. Focus on helping flow at the least, at the point of the least restricted. Let me talk more about that. So R.H. Kipps brought up that on your valve, getting it back cut and radiusing where it seats in the valve seat, that is certainly a point of greatest restriction. It's the bottleneck. It's the point where it's most difficult to get your flow. Machinist ridge around it is also a great restriction, because then the flow, the valve has to come up all the way pretty much before it's really getting flow. But the moment it starts to open, if you get that machinist ridge, it has more flow around it. Okay, so remember, when your piston comes down, unless it's like a diesel, when your piston comes down, that's not really what feels the volume. most of why your cylinder fills with air-fuel mixture when it comes down is because of the flow that's actually still going out the exhaust. Because that valve is closing as your piston's coming down. That's what sucks in the air charge more than anything else. That's why if you go to more of a race cam, or maybe a half mix between street and race cam, in my case, since I'm really not going to race my car, just not. It's terrible for insurance purposes. Increasing your lobe separation makes it so that your exhaust can help scavenge and pull the intake charge even better. It does mean you waste a little bit of your air-fuel mix, just a little bit more, but it raises your dynamic compression. That's not the actual physical shape of compression, but the results of how you get all your flow. The other side of greatest restriction is in the bowl. So you got your valve, you got your compression chamber, we're talking about that side. You go to the other side, and you've got the bowl right behind where the valve seats. This is where the air actually comes, and fuel, unless we're talking about like a direct injection, which is a whole other story. You've got to work in that bowl. Oftentimes, right underneath that valve seat is a rough area. If you shape and smooth that and smooth your transitions so that you have less kind of hard movements and smooth everything out, take it to an 80 grit finish, then you're in a lovely place. If you simply focus on port shape, you can get the most out of it. Like your valve guides, you could flow them into the shape of a teardrop, for example, you know, or like a raindrop. That would get the best flow around them so that where the valve guide is, it would restrict movement of air less as it goes over it. Because as a standard, they're a simple circle, but you create more of a raindrop shape and air will split around it better and have less of restriction. These are more minor things. Biggest mistake you can make is you can polish your combustion chamber. That's not bad. When you polish your combustion chamber, you're going to reduce carbon buildup and reduce hot spots where you'll have little tiny pre-ignition moments before you want it to happen, which will reduce the effect of your timing advance. Now, you don't want to do better than 80 grit. And recently I heard David Vizard say, even though it was a few years ago, that you're wasting your time to go even beyond 60 grit. I have a whole bunch of 80 grit rolls. Sorry, David, I'm going to use them. So the point being is that all the little tiny imperfections inside the port, if you have a nice 80 grit, it creates little tiny vertices, and those are like bearings to get the air to flow just beautifully through. If you polish your ports, you're slowing down the airflow. Let me repeat this. If you polish your ports, you're slowing down airflow. The common phrase is porting and polishing. Guess what I'm specifically not calling these videos? I'm calling them porting and airflow theory, because porting and polishing means porting and then slowing the air down. We don't want that, do we? Get out there and work on something. Or go to church, which is why I'm dressed up. That works too. Hey, serving God brings peace to your heart. Bringing peace to your heart makes it so when you're done with work, you actually want to work on your hobby instead of laze around and do nothing.